Hello everyone, my name is John Melisondra and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Okay, so today I'm gonna teach you on how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. And please don't forget to subscribe, you have to subscribe it and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notification my new videos and tutorials. Okay, so you can see all the materials needed in the screen. You can see there the 5mm colors, the brushes that we're gonna need, and all the things that we're gonna need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now. And first, we're gonna do a little sketching. I'll be using a smaller brush. It is the number 2 nylon flat brush. So I'll be using this number 2 nylon flat brush for a little sketching. And I'm going to mix raw umber and white. So I'm using the raw umber and white so that it will be easier for me to cover it with other colors, especially the yellow. Yeah. Okay, I'll try to paint a beautiful landscape, and I'm gonna put here a base, something here with some sunflowers. Yeah, it will be some flowers here. Yeah, I'll put it in the row of thirds, and I'm gonna put some flowers here, and my landscape will just be the background. There. Okay, so I'm gonna put some. Yeah, I'll just paint some typical mountains here, beautiful mountains. And I think I will put the tree here. I want to cover some parts here. Yeah, maybe like that. Because, wait. I want to put some, this bottom part. Maybe some rocks here. And this bottom part will be some flowers on the garden. And then I'm gonna put some mountains there. So it's very important, everyone, to have a plan before you're gonna start your painting. So you need to plan first. Yeah, do a little sketching, planning, brainstorming, something like that. So I'm not sure if I'm going to, but maybe I will just try to put here, yeah, some trees here, or just I want to make this some cloudy afternoon. Yeah, okay, so I think I'm gonna start now, and I'll try to put first some underpainting. I'm going to use some yellowish color because I want it again to be an afternoon. Always afternoon. Try to put it here. I want it to be lighter. I want it to be very relaxing afternoon. Yeah, just paint like this. A little red. There. You can clean your brush, but make sure that there's no paints on it. And then I have here some red and the blue color. It should be much more reddish. And then white. Yeah, I will try to make this part dark with some clouds there. Thank you. to just be a random clouds, everyone. But make it a little purple. It's a cloudy afternoon. It's about to rain. Okay, so I have here some more raw umber, and then white. No, I'm not raw umber, but purple. Sorry. Sometimes I'm not on my mind. I have here some white. Maybe I'm going to make it a little lighter orange on the bottom. There. Make it a little more abstract. There. Okay, so I have now a beautiful sky. I'm going to put some more reddish color here. Yeah, some dirty abstract colors for the sky. There. Okay. I have here the blue and the red. And then a little white. Now it's more bluish. And let's paint some mountains. Yeah, it's a little dark there. But not so dark, I want it to be lighter purples. That's cute. There. Yeah, I just want to make it plenty of colors there. Again, we're gonna mix for purple and then white. So this part of it, because we're gonna cover it with the sunflowers, so yeah, it's okay if it's not so clear here, that's fine. Do not make it too good. Yeah, there. And I'm gonna use a little darker. And a little more white. And then some blue. Same color here. Yeah. Okay, so I'll just try to have a sketch here. I'm gonna make it more yellowish or greenish this time. Okay. Maybe I'll put some
just make a smaller. This will be the horizon here. And this part, I'm gonna put some river. Yeah, it'll be better. Yeah, this will just be not so complicated tutorial, everyone. It will just be easy for the beginners. Yeah, there's some yellow. Okay, so everyone, if you just cover the sketch here, that's because it's just a sketch. Later, you can create those details. And then on the bottom, I think I will try to put some dark colors there. So here, I'll try the blue umber, and then some blue. So maybe I'll just put some blue umber in blue. So let's make it make that part darker. Okay, here we're gonna put some yellow. So everyone, there are plenty of noises outside. There. Okay, I will now start using a smaller brush. This one, so number 8 nylon flat brush. Yeah, it's number 8. Part will be the river, and my light is coming from the left side always. Okay, so I'm going to mix for much greenish color now. So I'll just put this purple here with some green, and let's start to put some near mountains. Okay, yeah, I just want dark colors this time. Yeah. And here I have the blue umber and the blue again, and the red. Just want to create, put more blue umber, a dark forest here. So this part will be a dark forest, and the base of the mountain, as always. Some trees or whatever you can find there. Okay. Some bushes here or something. Yeah. Okay. And then I'll try to put some highlights now. So I'm a little excited with the highlights. I'll just use this brush, which is number 8 nylon flat brush. So I'm not using my usual microphone today. So my microphone has no battery. I cannot find it here. So I'm using my other microphone, but it's much more noisy compared to the other one, but still noisy. My place is not so quiet. Sorry, everyone. Okay, so I have here some yellow and blue. I have no white, so I'm going to refill some white. Use the tapping technique like that. If your brush is old, that's better. It's only much more better than the new one. So make sure that the color is not so greenish or yellowish. Just a little. It should be much more bluish, everyone. Like the blue green, something like that. So I can find some trees, grasses here on this mountain. Okay, there. And also here. And then I want to put some blue here. You can put some bluish color here, but a little dark. This part was not hit by the sunlight, so it will become a little more bluish. So here, since we cover it with some flowers, so it's okay. You don't put anything here so much details on the other part, it's okay. Okay, that's good. Yeah, so you have no distant mountain, but not so misty like the previous thing that we painted. We'll try to make it a little more light, lighter. Maybe I'll try to put more details later on. This here, everyone, is okay. This is assumed that this part covered by the clouds, so it will be much more dark here. So it's fine. I want this to be light. The field, I want it to be lighter or something. So I'm gonna use more. Maybe orange and white. More yellow. Okay, that's good.
And also here.
Okay, everyone, if you are painting, maybe just follow what I'm doing. And always have fun. There. Yeah. Okay. So, I will try to put some more orange color. Yellow and red. Yeah, I'll just try to put some more orange color. And also here, you have to put some more. Okay, and then I'm going to start putting some water reflections on the river. Sorry, bro. There's some big truck there. Okay, I want it to be much more blue green. Yeah. Too much, maybe something like that. It should equal everyone here. Okay, and then some purple, just blue and red, and a little white to make it lighter. So I'm gonna put lighter purple on the in this part, little bottom, so that the reflection here can cast it here. There. And there's children's outside playing. Yeah, much more purple. Can put a little lighter. There. Okay. And then you can add a little darker here. later on can put much more shades there. Okay, for now, it's gonna be more, you cannot see clearly how good the details, but later we can put it there. Okay, so I will add more details. And maybe I'll try to put some trees here on this part. Maybe some pine trees of the one. What if we can? Okay, so I'll try to use again purple and a little amber. Okay. Just add purple and blue. No, blue, red, and a little amber. Yeah, I can just put some pine trees. And then you can put some casted shadows everyone here. Okay. There. I'll try to put some I'll try to use smaller brush. Put more blue. Have to put some branches, everyone. Yeah, just put some branches to make it look much more like pine trees. Okay, yeah. And here I'll try to put some darks or maybe some amber on this part here. Okay. Yeah, maybe later we'll put some details there, everyone. But for now, I'll try to put some reflection. We should before we forget. A little more bluish or greenish, but it should be dark. Put through amber. Yeah. And then we're gonna put the reflection here. It's a downward stroke, one on top of everything you see on the top. There. Okay. Okay, so on this part, I'm gonna put some light colors that it's like hit by the sun. There should be some grasses here. that doesn't get hit by the sun on the back part, everyone. So that's very important. So I'm gonna put there. I will be using the fun brush. So I have here the fun brush. Let's put the yellow everyone color. And put a lot more yellowish grasses here. Okay, looks good. Yeah. Sorry everyone if there are some noisy people outside. Okay. I think that looks good. And the reflection looks good also. Okay. I really like those colors there. That's good. Okay, so I think I will start adding a sketch here for the base so that I will finish it. It will become dry. Until here everyone, I'll try to put some disturbance here, like some trees. Yeah, I'm going to use this brush. Yeah, I'll try to put some plenty of trees there in the back because it's too quiet there. I want it to be looking busy, so I'm gonna use this dark color, blue, amber, and red. I'm using the flat brush, everyone. Resolve flat brush. This part will be balanced. Maybe I want to put more here. Let's use the topping technique, everyone. put more. Yeah, I'll just mix everything here. Add some brownish. Purple, blue, and red. Just to make that part dark. Okay. And also here. Sorry, everyone, if my background is so noisy. Okay, so here I'm gonna put the base. Yeah, I'll try to sketch everyone the base using the umber. Sorry, everyone, noisy background. Okay, so this will be a flower base here. Yeah, I'm gonna put the sunflower. It'll be really good. It is in front of wood, so I'm gonna put the wood here. To be a little perspective. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to continue everyone. I'm going to add some more details here in this part. I will put some dark colors here. This will be some plants here. Okay, but I'll try to make it dark first, so that we can have a better foundation in the background. Okay, and I will try to put, using the fan brush, I'll try to put some greenish things there, whatever I can find there. Blue. And then, umber. I'm gonna use this yellow and blue with some greens. Just use the topping here, huh? Using the fine brush. Okay. Ito po siya, may ito lighter. Hello. Maybe white. Maybe some flowers there. As you can see, different varieties of colors there, everyone. It's good. And then some orange. Or maybe the red. So one reds, let's represent some flowers there. Okay. Yeah, I think I like the view of the room. That's good. It looks very refreshing. Okay. And then, of course, I need to put some details on these pine trees because it's so lonely. I'm gonna use this blue with some little yellow and white. Some colors here to make it look like there's some colors in this part. Okay, so I think that looks good, but I need to put some highlights on the other side, light yellow. I'm using the small brush, everyone, because it's easier to use this one. Just one tap and drop, and you can create those details that you want. There. Okay, so the light is coming from the left side, so it should be, the color should be like this. And the next one will be this one. Yeah, maybe I'll just try to use this same brush. But you can use the fun brush here, but anyway, I'll just cover some parts here, so it won't matter so much. There, just tapping technique and create those beautiful. Maybe I will try to put more bigger leaves here to create more details. Okay, I will use a smaller brush, a liner brush now. So, I'm trying to find my liner brush. So that I can put much smaller details. So it's important, everyone. So I'll try to put some yellowish details there on the back. And of course here. You look on the back side. It's just a liner brush, a round brush, small one. There. Okay, and then I'll try to use this white with the yellow. Look like there's a white colored flowers here. Just make it look like busy, everyone. But there are a lot of things there. Okay, I think that looks good. Yeah, it looks like that there are a lot of things there. And that's very important when you're painting like this. And also the lights there, the dynamic colors. We should see a lot there. Okay. I will try to put more white here. Okay, so that we can also see that there are plenty of lights striking on this part. Okay, I'll try to create some light greens. I will try to put some grasses here. Just a quick strokes, everyone, like this to create some grasses. Just not too much, everyone, just enough for this part. And also here. A little bluish. You can also put a little bluish again. A little bluish, you can put it on the dark part. And you can use some yellowish tone. Some brighter colors. Okay. We can try to put some reds. It's just like there's pretty flowers there. Make it look that part pretty colorful. Yeah, it's also good to do like that. Okay, now I'm going to put something on my base. Yeah, it's dry and it's good. I'll try to put first the brown here. It's not so much big. This is the center of the flower. You can use the raw umber directly. There. And then also here. Yeah, we can put bigger. I like bigger. My place is so noisy. Okay. I think I'll try another one here, but it will be a little facing on this part. So we can just do like this. There. Yeah. And then we'll put the stem. Just green, everyone, or maybe a little darker green. Yeah, also here. These are just small sunflowers. Now I'll try to put some. I think. By the way, everyone, I'm using the small number 2 flat brush. I'm going to use this one again, and then red to make some. Orange. Yeah, just one strokes. One stroke. There. Sorry, we had plenty of kids there. They're from neighbors.
Okay.
Just make it circle, everyone here. Okay. There. And then the other one. Okay, it is facing the light, and then I will now start putting the leaves. Can I just screen everyone? Yellow, and I will be using the same brush. It will always look like a heart, everyone, like that. Okay. There. So we all have, we all need now the highlights. Yeah. And I think that would be good to go. 1 hour and 2 minutes. I'll be finishing this one. I will now put the highlights of using the raw umber, the yellow, and the red. Yellow on the umber. And then I'm gonna put the umber here on the bottom. It should be rounded here on the bottom, everyone, on the base, because of the perspective. Okay. There. Okay, raw umber and the blue to make some dark. And red. This is a casted shadow from this leaf. Okay. Let's make this darker, the background. There, and also here. Yeah, we'll try to go a little dark. And cast a shadow here. Yeah. And then I'm gonna make this period. I'm gonna make this dark. Old wood, something like that, or the death, or a devil. Yeah, I'm gonna put a light brown. See outside. Now you see children's and anything there. Yeah. Just make the details a little regular or something. To make it look like an old wood. Sorry about that, still great. It's a little noisy there. Hi, sorry. I hope this children will be quiet. I don't know what can I do. Okay. It's hard to live in an apartment. Some people doesn't respect. I'm gonna make it a little darker here. Okay. Yeah, so we have not this or something there. And now let's put the highlights on our sunflower. And I'm excited to put the yellow, everyone. I want the brightest yellow to put there. Here, just one strap, okay. Just like that. Okay. And also here. There. And maybe I'll just try to retouch here. Good. Now looking as if for some flowers there. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to put now details on the leaf. I'm gonna make the light greens. Okay. Okay, yes, well now some highlights here. I want it to be lighter. And put another size that is really hit by the sun. Okay, and I will try to put some tiny details on this on the flowers, the leaves. Okay, sorry everyone, this children is really, really noisy. You can create the veins. I don't know where are the parents of these children. Okay, just to create the details, good details there. Okay, I'll try to put some whites. And then, not just whites, but darks here. Green and umber and the blue. It's very important to put some darks also, everyone, because I think I forgot. Okay, I think that looks cute. Yeah, and the sunflowers are really looking good. Now I'm going to retouch, it's the last part. And it's been almost 1 hour and 20 minutes. I think we'll finish at 1 hour and 20 minutes. I'll just retouch everyone, just a little. The base. I'm gonna use the orange and then white. Just to make this rounded. I'll just make this a little light on this part. That was a reflection coming from the floor, from the table. Just make it a regular like this, pretty textures there. Okay, I think that looks good. Okay, just one more thing, everyone. I'm going to put highlights on the flowers on the center. Before I forget, I almost forget. I just mix the orange. Yeah, just orange, and then here. Just select that. You can create dots like this. Create some flower seeds. But it's okay if you just do like this. Okay, more yellows. Also the center, I can put lights. Yeah. Okay, one. We need to put more. Okay, I think that looks now some flowers. With the one, I'm going to put some highlights in the center. Okay, one more. Because it doesn't look realistic for me. Just great dots there. Tiny dots in these flowers. Anyway, this is the last part. Okay, and then one more thing, everyone. I'm going to solid make the petals solid. Just a light yellow. Okay, that's all, everyone. So it's 1 hour and 24 minutes. I want to say thank you for watching this video today. It will not be so easy, everyone. So, but it's just some more like between easy painting and advanced tutorial. So the details is not so complicated. It's just plenty. I just put more using the brushes, all the brush techniques. But everything there is not so complicated, and I know that you can also do it. Even the beginners can also do it. And I hope you're happy with the result. I also love the result there. It's good. And I say thank you for watching this video today. Maybe I will also add some more highlights there, maybe later. And also here, some more highlights. Just to make this distance much more realistic, some white things there. So you can see it, the final result. And I'll just put some highlights there on this mountain, and that's all. Okay, everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praise always belongs to the Lord.